What's good, guys? It is Trav here from Neighbourhood. Are you struggling to add and update data inside HubSpot in bulk? You might need to learn how to import records and activities into your portal. Today, we're going to go over two types of imports, single and multiple, and the types of records and activities that can be imported. If you want to take today's lesson offline though, we'll include a free downloadable PDF in the description below. Two things we're going to do today. First one is just a standard import. So I've got a whole bunch of data that I want to put inside HubSpot, first name, last name, all that sort of jazz. The second part is that I want to go ahead and I've got one spreadsheet that has all of my customer data on it, but I've also got another spreadsheet of all of the deals that I've got. And I want to make sure that I can create deals but associate them with the contacts as well. Now, the method that I've got is similar to the same for each of the objects. So for the deals and the contacts, but if you've got tickets, the whole preface kind of like is much the same. I will say if there's any questions around this at all, we're pretty quick on the reply. So if you hit down at the in the comments below, we can help you out. But if you got an emergency and you need to talk to somebody right now, they're usually in the bottom, either one of the corners here, there's an orange button, help button. You can click on that and HubSpot chat, not very far away. I will also say that the knowledge base on site HubSpot have got heaps of information, but usually people don't like reading 20,000 words to try and get this one done. So hopefully this short video will show you how to do it fairly quickly. Okay, so first and foremost to import. So we're gonna go to contacts and go to the main contacts area. You'll see this is our demo account. So we've got obviously a whole bunch of stuff in here that's test, test, test. Up top right-hand side, you'll see the import button. So the first thing we're gonna do today is just a standard import. Nice and standard, nothing too crazy. So we're gonna click on the import button. And we are going to click on this import, start and import. It's going to give us three options: file from computer, opt-out list, or integrations. Now, obviously we want to upload a file from the computer, but if we ever have got a bunch of people that wanted to opt out or from a third-party platform, you could also do that. Also the import objects from installed apps, but we're just going to go for the first one for now. Click on this one and go next. All right, so now we are going to import one file. The next part we'll do is multiple files with associations. That's where it gets a little bit complex depending how it is, but we'll go through and we're gonna do just the one file on this one. So we're gonna click on next. Now, one object or multiple objects. So in this instance, what we wanna do is we're just gonna do one object because I'm just uploading content contact data. Now the next step that I'm going to do is actually going to be multiple objects because I'm going to import contacts and deals and I want them to merge together, but I'm going to be doing that with two files. Sometimes the files can all be sort of like within the one sort of all of the objects can be in the one file. Depending on how it is, this is where it gets a bit complex. In my instance, I've got one spreadsheet, two spreadsheets, one with the contact, one with the deals. Sometimes that information's in one and it can be very messy. But in this instance, I'm going to do just one object, which is the contact information, and click on next. Wowee, what a lot of little boxes. These are growing every single day. So what we want to do is we are importing the contact property here. And we're going to click on next. Okay, so what we want to do, it's got a bunch of information here as well, but we want to make sure that we click here to upload the file. So we're going to click on this one here. We are going to, it's called 100 contacts on this one. Guess how many contacts are in there? 100. So we're going to click on next. Now, this is kind of when the fun part happens. We're gonna go through and we're basically going to match the top of the file name into its retrospective property. Now HubSpot kind of goes through and tries to do this itself already, hence why there's a lot of green ticks already, so I don't really necessarily need to do anything in this instance. But you wanna make sure when you import them, and if I kind of kick across here, so you'll see here at the very top of the CSV file, this is what HubSpot is reading. So the last name, first name, company name, and it's automatically associating it with pre-existing properties that are inside HubSpot. So what I will say is before you import, just make sure that those top headings do have the retrospective name for that property in that area. Any issues, get the comments. We can help you out with any questions that you've got. So we're gonna go back here. We're just gonna double check our math. We don't wanna completely go across. So first name, James Joseph Art. We wanna go back here. James Joseph and Art, they're the first three ones. That makes sense. We want last name, but whatever those names are. So it looks like these are pulling company, Benton. So we wanna go through. Now, if you want, you can go through every single one of these just to make sure. I trust it, but we want to go through and see if there's, so we can see here there's one unmapped one. So there's phone. It's probably a really good example that one of these properties here and one of these properties, phone one and phone, it doesn't really necessarily tell us exactly what type of phone that is. So in this instance, this one here, this could be phone number, but let's just say that this one is mobile phone number. So we want to map it. So look for the mobile phone number. If you're importing a property that doesn't have one inside HubSpot, you can create a brand new one, but we'll go through here. It's giving us all ticks. And look, this is all good. And I'm gonna click on next. Now, a few final details. It's importing of the name, and we can create a list from this import if we need to as well. Now, select the legal basis, our contact data. You'll need to make sure that this is. So we wanna make sure that they're existing customers, but enter the relevant information that's relevant to how you got that list. Remember, it is bad practice to go ahead and buy lists and put them into HubSpot. If you get really, really bad unsubscribe bounces and things like that as well, it will flag you and it might temporarily lock your account too. So anyway, it's a little bit of, but we'll go back here. You can see that it is imported 99 new records, must be 100 including the heading, with no errors whatsoever. So if I go back to contacts, I should be able to see those 99 here. It should be at the top. So these are all of the new ones that I have just imported there. If I go back there, I can probably see the relevant ones there. So now what we wanna do is we wanna import the deals with the multi-associations of the different types of objects as well. So what I've done is I've made a small edit to the file that we've got here. And what I've done is I've added the specific information for the deals that we've got in here. So you'll see the extra one that we've got here is deal name, deal amount, the deal create date, and then also the sales pipeline and the stage. That's just got to obviously drop into which stage inside your CRM that it's going to actually populate. So in order for us to do this, now that we've updated this one, so you can import them both at the same time if you like. This is just a second way to do it. So we'll go through, we'll go to import. We're gonna go to start and import, file, computer, and we'll with one file, and we want multiple objects. We wanna click on contacts and deals. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna upload this file that we've got here. And we're going to click on next. And it's scanning for all of this here. So what we can look here now is this is all the contact properties, which it's automatically mapping. Phone number, so we're going to go through here on a contact property. We'll go mobile, if we remember we did that last time. Deal amounts, so this is a deal property. So we're going to click on deal properties. And I think it's called amount, which is good. So I'm going to map that. The create stage, so we're gonna create the dates. So it's usually called create date, there we go. And then the stage, create date. It's coming up with a bit of an error. There's a format that they just sort of don't understand, so depending on how it's imported, you can go through and just manually upload that. I know that the US and Australia have different types of conventions when it comes to it. So in this instance, what we're gonna do is we're just going to don't import the column just to make it easy for this example. We're gonna click on next. We're gonna go through the numbering format. We wanna go Australia in this instance. And we're gonna say that they are existing customers and we wanna finish that import. So we'll go through, it's going through. It should come up and spin up a record to say that it's no longer updating the contacts, but also updating the deals. So you can see here that it's gone through and it's completed with no errors and it's updated 99 records with 99 new associations, which makes sense because it's associated 99 deals to 99 different types of contacts. That sounds confusing. We'll click on deals and in no contact should have 99
new ones called deal number 9. And if we click through to these, we should have an association to the relevant contact. You beauty, there it is. So remember, you can do it one of two ways. You can just import the contacts, nice and simple. Or if you've got all the information on one CSV, you can go and import them and then just map the individual columns to the retrospective object and then property in that object. And there you have it.
And there you have it. You now know how to import records into HubSpot. If you're after a PDF version of what you've learned today, we'll leave a link in the description below. And if you've learned something new from this video and you're keen to learn more about HubSpot, make sure you give us a like, subscribe, and hit that bell so you never miss out on another video. Well, that's it from me, guys, and happy HubSpotting.